All right, another weekend in the shop, back working on the Trans Am again. And like we finished off the last video, today we gotta rip the rear diff out, weld these in properly. While the diff's out, the springs will be hanging. Fill this in properly. Might get to working on the fuel system here, clean all this up, put it under here, maybe lose some more line, more weight. And we'll see where we go from there. Obviously, you gotta put the rear brake lines in, but gonna do that once I got the diff back in its spot again, so everything can be nice and neat and clean. And we'll see where the day takes us. So the next time you see this diff, it'll be on my little homemade diff stand on my tranny jack. Made this little thing up. It is nice to have. I have adjustment here, I have adjustment there, I have adjustment on these, so it'll fit all kinds of different diffs. And we'll rip the diff out and put it on there. All right, so we made quite a bit of progress on the race car so far. Rear diff is out, sitting way over there. We'll get to that in a second. The fuel system, showed you on the last video, we had a bunch of leaks and stuff coming from the back here. What we've done is I'm basically redoing the whole system. With the old system, which is here in pieces, there was stainless steel line, which is great, a solid line, kind of cool, but the way too many junctions between the fuel cell and the fuel pressure regulator. There had to be 15 junctions places, and junctions are places that can leak, so that's way too many. So what I've done is I've moved my fuel pump that was here, and now we've tucked it underneath the car just in case, you know, bigger wheelies and stuff. You don't want this stuff head anywhere close to the ground. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, and then the next one will be at the regulator. One line all the way from here up to the regulator. 5 junctions from 15 down to 5. Makes things a lot simpler, way less chances of leaking. And then as long as you route your lines and everything properly, it makes everything way better, and nothing will have a problem with it. So let's go jump over to the diff. All right, you can see, got everything fully welded on the perches now. It was nice. Just put it on my stand, rotate it over. Perches are at the top. Easy peasy weld it, paint it, and we're good to go. So once I get all the stuff with the fuel system all sorted out again, because, you know, one thing always leads to another. Painted the new lower Caltrac parts too. If I had time, it would be really nice to send this stuff out for powder coat, but I can't have everything sitting on the freaking hoist for days and days and days. So once we're done with the fuel system, put the diff back up in, and then actually, while I have the diff out, we'll build these plates in here, strengthen that up even more. And then I do have, finally showed up, my guys at Coast Powertrain here in Prince George built me a nice steel drive shaft, 1350 series U-joints. It'll handle way more horsepower than I'm throwing at it. The only reason we did that is I had to extend it a little bit because, like I said, the 9-inch is a little bit shorter than the Chevy 12 bolt. So 1.25 inches longer, so I had to build a whole new drive shaft, which kind of sucks, but it happens when you're doing all this stuff. So that'll be nice to have in here. And then we can finalize all the rear suspension today and be back on the ground and ready to terrorize the drag strip. All right, make some more progress. All right, so there we go. We're gonna call it a day at the end of Saturday here. Got those triangulated and welded in. I've painted everything black. You can see I've cut out quite a bit of metal back here because it did hang down to about there before. So we're way up here. Looked much better. Primed everything, painted it black. Cut a couple more things off up here, just extra stuff you don't need. As you can see, I've got my line all plumbed in all the way to the front. The only place it's not tight right now is there, because what I want to do is disconnect it from making the new line, I'm gonna run a little bit of fuel, run the fuel pump a little bit, run some fuel through it, and just to flush out the new line from all the rubber and stuff that for making it. So I'll run a little bit of fuel through it. I still have to make the connection yet. And the rear suspension is just about done on this thing, but I gotta let painted this while it's still pretty hot. So I gotta let everything cool, so we might as well just call it a day. And it's been a few hours, definitely. Everything seems to be coming along quite nicely, and we'll get more at her in the morning. All right, we are back working on the Trans Am again on this wonderful Sunday. To mount the rear brake line here, going from the frame, the flex line, from the frame to the diff, all I did was take a 5/16 bolt, weld it to the top of the diff. You get a nut there, you can secure it. The reason, you're probably wondering why this is zip tied here, and you've seen that one zip tied there. The wrong adapters came. So they sent me -4 instead of -3, which if anybody knows AN fittings, that's a 16th of an inch difference. So -3 is 3/16, -4 is 4/16, basically quarter inch. So they sent me the wrong fitting, so now I'm waiting. And for now, I just have bolts in here so I don't lose this stuff. I have to get proper banjo bolts. Do not use regular bolts. There's no way for the fluid to get through. So I gotta get proper banjo bolts that have the holes in them to let the fluid through to the rear calipers. Everything is torqued down. I cut off the excess on the bolts, these half inch bolts, like 100 foot pounds of torque. If you go bigger, you need more torque. If you go smaller, you need less torque. Whoever's bending your U-bolts should be able to get you that information. All right, and we got the new drive shaft in place. As you can see, the proper U-bolts in there now, that it's not temporary and I'm not just idling it around because everything's fully welded, installed, all that kind of good stuff. Those are nice, welded, painted. So now what I gotta do is clean up my mess. As you can see, mess everywhere again from working. And move these around so that we can hook it up over here now. And so we're gonna clean up some mess, lower the car down, and we can get started on that. Okay, we're in the trunk now. And you can see the battery I have in here. I actually just put this battery in temporarily because my old one totally crapped right out. This one's an RV battery. And for those of you that are running without an alternator, this is a great style of battery to run. Because an RV battery can be used as starting charging, which most automotive cars and stuff use, which means they're not meant to be drained right down. They're meant to take voltage spikes out of the system. They're meant to store energy for starting and stuff like that. But the alternator is meant to charge. Most alternators are not meant to charge from a battery that is completely dead, for those of you that don't know. They're meant to maintain a charge and do small top-ups on the battery. So if you drain a battery the right down to completely dead, and you fire up your car and let it charge with just the alternator, it's actually going to be really hard on the alternator, build up a lot of heat in it, and wear it out prematurely. So because we run an alternator, we don't need to run the RV style, because the RV style also allows you to drain it right down and bring it right back up, where a normal battery doesn't like doing that. So it's half starting charging, half deep cycle is what they call that. So you drain the electricity right out of it, you can boost it, bring it right back up, and it's meant to do that. So we don't need that feature of it. So what we're gonna do, this battery is actually, I just put it in here temporarily. I did have a bigger battery in here that died. It's been in there for years, so I'm not surprised that it finally kicked the bucket. All of you know, racing is weight. So this battery is coming out. These mounts are coming out because they look, they definitely do the job, but it looks kind of hillbilly-ish to me. So I managed to get this little battery holder and this much smaller battery. You can see by the size of my hand that battery. You can see by the size of my hand that battery. So this battery is strictly a starting charging battery because the car is always in nice warm temperatures 90% of the time when I start it. I don't need a huge battery. So smaller, lighter, nicer looking, hold down. So what I'm gonna do is take the base and we're gonna mount it. What we're gonna do though is move it back to the very rear of the car. Instead of having it up here, we're gonna move it back further into the rear of the car here, just moving more weight back. Because the further back you can have the weight, the better it is for traction and all that kind of stuff. So that's how we're gonna make up for the extra weight, is we're just gonna move the battery back. So I'm gonna get started on that project, get rid of all this stuff, and get her done properly. All right, so we got everything hooked up here again. We got the battery in, secured. Terminals all redone. Wiring, moved the fuel pump wiring. Nice little grommet to go through the floor there. It's all up there. And another thing I also did was, on these race cars, you're supposed to have a light on the back of the car that comes on when you're going down the track. So I removed these, and this light and this light now will come on when the fuel pump is engaged. So I removed all the rest of the wiring. And as you can see, everything's nice, neat, clean. So that's what these two wires that go in there are, the blue and the red. They go to the two outside lights. So a little 194 bulb, so I actually have something on there to be legal. But yeah, it turned out pretty good. So battery, new battery is right at the very back of the trunk. Just enough room I can access this and the stuff for to get these off. And shave those two huge pieces of ready rod off. Fuel pump, everything's in. Fuel's back in the tank. Everything seems to be working pretty good. I fired the system up. Ran some fuel through the lines. You can see some of the junk in the bottom there that it flushed out. So what I'm going to do is run it through a paint filter for like automotive painting and stuff like that. They always filter their paint and stuff like that. So I'm going to run the fuel through that, put it back in the tank, keep all the junk out. But yeah, now everything looks nice, neat, simple, clean. Tightened everything up, fired up the fuel system, checked for leaks. Everything's really good. No leaks, no drips. The car is ready to move under its own power again. Got the battery done, the fuel system done. These last 2 weeks has been a lot accomplished. But yeah, she's getting real close to going here. Couple more projects to do, but they're not nearly as big as all this stuff in the back. But yeah, we're gonna put the back tires back on it, call it a day, and we'll have to start a new project next time.